All right, I'd like to thank everybody for attending. We're going to declare the ivory-billed woodpecker extinct. It was last seen over 60 years ago, so I think this is a pretty clear-cut decision. So all in favor, say... What was that? Who could that be? The ivory-billed woodpecker was the largest species of woodpecker in the United States, with a wingspan of 30 inches. Basically a woodpecker the size of a crow, if you can believe it. They were abundant across the southeast in the old-growth forests and swampland with gigantic bald cypress trees. They built nests by digging a cavity in trees up to 70 feet tall. And they ate by using their large, powerful beaks to strip bark from trees and get at the bugs underneath. Because of their size, ivory-billed woodpeckers needed a lot of habitat to find enough food. Each pair is estimated to need between 6 and 17 square miles of old-growth forest to live. But the amount of undisturbed old-growth forest changed following the Civil War in the 1860s. In the industrial deforestation of the South following the Civil War, it's not clear that enough habitat was left for the species to remain stable. But that was not the last large-scale disaster to affect this species. The Great Depression caused subsistence hunting across the country, and a large woodpecker could provide food for hungry families. As they declined, ivory-billed woodpeckers were ironically hunted as museum specimens. In 1939, the total ivory-billed woodpecker population was estimated at 24 individuals. The last confirmed ivory-billed woodpecker sighting was by an artist in the Singer Tract in 1944, after the area had mostly been cleared for lumber. Searches for the ivory-billed woodpecker have continued since then. There are four unique features that searchers are looking for as evidence of the ivory-billed woodpecker. The distinct noise of them feeding is a double knock. Their call was described as being like a toy trumpet by John James Audubon. It's called a Kent call today. They have a backpack of white feathers with white lines going up to the head. And unlike other woodpeckers, they have white secondary wing feathers and a white leading edge on their underwing. Here's a map of reported sightings of ivory-billed woodpeckers since 1944. There are dozens. Just as an example of one of these sightings, in 1999, a forestry graduate student reported seeing an ivory bill in the Pearl River Wildlife Management Area. A volunteer search in 2000 turned up nothing, and another aerial search in 2001 also turned up nothing. And there are still people who are actively looking for the ivory-billed woodpecker today. Are they wasting their time? This wouldn't be the first bird species rediscovered after a long gap. Consider the cherry-throated tanager, who was last seen in Brazil in 1941. Sightings were reported in 1994, but it took until 1998 to confirm a population of 10. The long gap in this story can give us hope, but the population of 10 shows the magnitude of this challenge. We may be looking for a dozen or less ivory-billed woodpeckers in a search area the size of the Southeast United States. Over the decades of searching, the technology of searching has advanced. From binoculars and black and white cameras in the early days, people are now using motion-activated trail cameras and autonomous sound recording units. And field researchers are playing ivory-billed woodpecker calls and listening for a response. So far, there has been no answer. In 2021, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service proposed to remove the ivory-billed woodpecker from the endangered species list due to it being extinct. This triggered a release of several reputable sightings and intense analysis by ornithologists. There is no unambiguous photo or video or audio recording that proves the ivory-billed woodpecker is alive. But there was enough evidence that maybe they exist. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service extended the deadline and are currently asking for the public to submit any sightings or comments about the ivory-billed woodpecker. They will review them over the coming months before making a final decision.
I'm not sure if the ivory-billed woodpecker is alive or not. It would be a happy, surprising discovery if it were. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments. You can subscribe to this channel to get a double knock every time there's a new video. If you'd like to join the BioBush flock, you can support us on Patreon or as a channel member. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.